was a raging success. It was the biggest rock concert Brisbane's ever seen. In fact, one of the biggest ever held in Australia. And the boss, as he's called, didn't let his fans down. Chris Allen went along for this exclusive look at the performance that left Bruce saying, "Love you, Brisbane."
They started queuing the night before. It was cold and wet. By midday on Sunday, the lines to get into Brisbane's massive QEII Stadium stretched 5 kilometres. This was to be Springsteen's biggest ever concert. Constant announcements kept warning the crowds there would be no alcohol allowed in and no cameras. There would also be another 4 hours before the American singer took to the stage. But his reputation was enough for the fans to live on.
All right, are you all very excited about this?
Yes!
Are you worried about the rain?
No!
What's a famous ex-radio announcer like you doing in a place like this?
Hanging around and see a rock show and eating a drumstick and just coming along to enjoy some spirited rock and roll.
He's so cute, bottom.
Is that why you've come, to see his bottom?
No, because he's fantastic. He's the best in the world.
When the gates opened, the stampede was on. By 5 o'clock, an estimated 45,000 were inside. At the front of the stage, it was a battle between teenagers and their parents for the best position. The man they call the boss seems to appeal to all age groups. For some, the wait and the crush was too much. By 6:30, the crowd was near hysteria. In concert, Springsteen is dynamic, dramatic, and exhausting. A huge video screen above the stage relayed his image to the grandstands at the back. Despite a few gate crashes, the crowd was well behaved, and Springsteen managed to keep them entertained for 3.5 hours. Before the cheering was over, Springsteen was whisked out of the stadium in a minibus to his city hotel, and thousands queued for hours to get home. Springsteen's next concert is in Melbourne. In Brisbane, Chris Allen reporting for 11am.
And that's Chris Allen, who of course filed that report down to Sydney a little earlier in the day. We'll take, I beg your pardon. Hello?
We have some more of Bruce.
When? Right now. Okay. All right. Well, apparently that was Chris's brief version for our early morning audience. He also has a longer version for you lucky people right now. Let's take it straight away.
People in Brisbane's QEII Stadium. This was the first time the scene of the Commonwealth Games had been used for a rock concert.
And certainly tonight's got to be the biggest and best. Bruce Springsteen and the E Street Band.
Rain was sprinkling down, but at the front of the stage, it was hot. Most of these people had been queuing for hours to get in, and they weren't all teenagers who'd parted with $22 each to see Springsteen. The man they call the boss seems to appeal to all age groups. By sundown, the expected 45,000 were chanting for the American singer, and there were no surprises for his opening number.
Yeah.
This was the biggest concert of Springsteen's career. In the States, he mostly plays indoors. Above the stage, a huge video screen relayed the action to the back of the stadium, and the action was worth waiting for. In the matter of a few songs, Springsteen takes the audience from bopping to tears, introducing his reflective numbers with dramatic monologues. But more than anything, he has energy. He jumped, jived and sang till he was hoarse, and that was just the first half of the show. For those who weren't at the concert, it must be hard to understand who Springsteen is. He doesn't give interviews, at least not in Australia. He's been big in the States for 10 years, but it was his last album, Born in the USA, and the hit song Dancing in the Dark, that took him to the top in this country. Man, I'm just tired and bored with myself. Hey, baby, baby. I could use just a little bit. You can't start. Much of his mystique is surely based on media hype, but after watching him in concert, there's no doubt he can move an audience more than any rock singer has done before. He plays for 3.5 hours and leaves his fans wrung out.
The Boss in